dry. Do you know? Hey y'all, Kristen here, and welcome back to my channel. If you're interested in minimalism, simplifying, and healthy living, then stick around. So if you've ever struggled with getting rid of items in your closet, you've been hanging on to them for a long time, maybe a few months, maybe several years, and you've just really been struggling with really getting rid of and letting go of those items in your closet, then this video is for you. Jump on in and let's get started. Some of the things that I found to be helpful is asking myself some questions and really being honest and digging deep into why I struggle with letting go of these items, journey through some of those emotions and the emotional baggage that may be attached to some of the items in my closet. So the question number one is, am I using this item regularly? Now for you, you have to kind of determine what that is for you. For me, that means when it's in season, so my in-season capsule summer wardrobe, it means that I need to be wearing it at least once every week. Now for you, it may be less than that, but I would challenge you to consider how often are you wearing it. If you're only wearing it once every single season, you know, is that item really getting the value and worth? But the second question is, do I feel confident in it? Especially as females, we're like, well, if I just lost another 5 pounds, another 10 pounds, or then that item would fit me better, then I would fit that item, right? And so we create this idea in our mind, in our head, that, oh, well, someday I'll fit into that item or I'll fit back into that. And the reality is that as females, our lifestyle changes, right? There's so many factors that go into like our body weight fluctuating, and really asking yourself, being honest with this question and exploring it a little bit deeper, is it making you feel confident? Because if every time you open your wardrobe, it brings a sense of shame, it brings a sense of guilt, like, oh my gosh, I paid all this money for this item and now I wore it only once or twice or a few times, or maybe I wore it 0 times and it still has the tags on it. If it doesn't fit you correctly and is too small, it likely is not gonna make you feel like your best self. The third question is, am I only keeping it because I paid money for it? Because there's that sense of like guilt associated with like buying an item and not using it. Whether that's because you spent a certain amount on it, whether it's like, oh my gosh, like it took gallons of water to make this item and it's harmful to the environment that I'm not wearing it. Wherever that guilt is coming from, this is me saying that it's okay to let that item go. Just because you paid money for it, that doesn't mean that you have to keep it. We are human beings and we are going to make mistakes, including myself. I'm going to be sharing a few pieces here that I have purchased that there's some regret there in purchasing them and how I worked towards letting them go. The fourth is, does this item bring me value? Does it honestly bring me value? That kind of ties into, are you actively wearing and using the item in your closet? And you have to kind of determine what that is, what that looks like. But if it's just sitting in your closet and it's been sitting there for months or for years, it's probably not bringing you value. Number five, this is where we're getting a little bit deeper here. Does this item create negative emotions in me when I see it? When I open my closet, does it create negative emotions? So maybe it creates feelings of sadness, feelings of guilt, right? I touched on that a little bit. So if it's creating negative emotions and it's making you feel less than, it's making you feel guilty, it's making you feel like you aren't the correct weight, like you aren't a beautiful human being, and that you're not beautiful, then it's time to let that item go. That item is not bringing you value. It's creating negative emotions. It's every time you open your closet, it's creating a sense of dread, because then your eyes are solely focused on that item versus the items that are actually bringing you value and the items that actually make you feel like your best self when you put them on. The next question I ask myself, question number six, is, does this item just make me feel bad? So not just negative emotions, but does it really, when you wear it and put it on, does it just make you feel bad about yourself? Like, are you constantly like that cycle of like negative thoughts and like, oh my gosh, that makes my hips look big, or it makes my butt look bad, or it makes, you know, are you digging in and really beating yourself up when you try this item on? And if that's true, then it's time to let that item go. Question number seven is, does this item fit? Okay, does it fit you, right? And I've kind of touched on this a little bit, but this is really the biggest one for me. And actually with the items that I have in my wardrobe currently, this is the biggest problem, an area that I've been addressing. I've talked about this a little bit, but I was diagnosed with irritable bowel syndrome, IBS. And so my weight has been fluctuating. And so that's been really challenging. And so a few of the pieces that have not been fitting me that I'm going to be getting rid of and how I worked through that. One of the first things is these jeans. You've probably seen me wear these in some of my videos. They were thrifted and I actually love them. They're definitely my style. They have like the pink stripes. They have the rips on them. They're more of like that casual mom jean style, but they are two sizes too big. And even with a belt, they're falling off. So unfortunately, this like hurts my heart because these are like one of my favorite thrifted pairs of jeans that I've ever found. As much as it pains me, I am going to be giving these away. Full disclosure, it's okay to like feel emotions when it comes to those things, because honestly, I felt really, really confident in these jeans, but I no longer feel confident in these jeans because they don't work well. They're uncomfortable. I'm constantly pulling them up. Put them in my closet and not worn them for probably about 3 months now. So yeah, it has taken me a little bit. So they've just sat there in my closet being unworn for 3 months, and I've gone back and forth on it. And I think that that's a natural process. So don't beat yourself up for that if it takes you some time. But really the most helpful thing that helped me work towards moving past and coming to this point today where I'm decluttering them, walking through all of these questions. So, you know, am I using this item? Nope. Do I feel confident in it? Not anymore. Did I used to? 100%. Do I anymore? Nope. Am I only keeping this item because I paid money for it? Yeah, partially yes. I mean, they were definitely cheaper because I thrifted them, so I didn't spend like $100 on them. Yeah, there's some guilt there in the amount of money that I spent on them. However, I've been learning, I kind of changed my language a little bit of, okay, I paid this money for them and they worked for me for a season. But right now in the season that I'm at, my weight is fluctuating due to different health and emotional things. So they're not fitting and working for me right now, and that's okay. I'm at a different stage of my life, and it's okay to let them go. Does this item bring me value? Nope. Creating negative emotions when I see it. Yeah, because then I feel guilty for the fact that my weight is fluctuating, and that every time I open my closet, I'm like, oh, there's those pair of jeans that I haven't gotten rid of that don't fit me anymore. Does this item make me feel bad? Yep, it does make me feel bad when I look at it. And does this item fit? No, it does not fit. So with me answering no to a lot of these questions and me having a lot of negative emotions tied to it, I know that letting go of those emotions is going to be a lot more beneficial for me emotionally and physically, letting them go versus keeping them. And I think that's an important thing to distinguish, is like, am I going to be better off emotionally and physically letting this item go versus keeping it in my closet? So as hard as it is to let go of that item, I have to know that I'd be better off without it. Other item that does not fit is this. It is a workout top. It's ribbed. It's like one of my favorite workout tops, but it doesn't fit me. So it's the Athleta brand. So a really good brand. I thrifted it. It is ribbed. It's one of my favorite colors, as you guys know, but it is a size medium. And if I was being completely, probably shouldn't have bought it because it's too big. It doesn't work. Like it gets in my way when I'm trying to exercise. And that's the purpose of my workout shirts and tops and shorts, is I want to be comfortable and I want to be able to work out really well and not be pulling on my shirt or worry about it getting hooked on equipment. These specific pants, I'll put up on the screen. I don't remember the exact pants. I'll find them. I'm pretty sure they still sell them. I do actually really like them. They're a thicker material and they have the stretchy waistband, but the elastic that they use on here, and I don't know if it's just how they make them, they're like smaller than what I thought. So I got them in a size extra small and they're too tight. This is like, so this extra small is like a size 00 or 000. It's too small. And every time I wear them, I'm uncomfortable because it's like sucking in at my waist. They're high waisted and it's too tight. This item is tied more to like the money question because I paid like $80 for these. That comes with more regret with regards to money. And that brings me to my next question. I asked myself, if I paid $5 for it, would I declutter it right now? And my answer is yes, because they don't fit, they're uncomfortable, I don't feel like my best self when I'm wearing them, I'm really only keeping them because I paid money for them, this item doesn't bring me value. I always like to think of it as, you purchase a item of clothing and you take it out of the store, it immediately loses like more than 50% of its value. Like, you're not getting that money back. In your bag, you leave the store, it is not worth what you paid for it. It just isn't. It's like buying a car and driving it off the lot. Once it's off the lot and you've purchased it, it's not worth near as much as what you paid for it. The other question that I ask myself with regards to money that has helped me is my money, or the money that I spent in the past on this clothing piece, worth more than my happiness and self-acceptance? Like, honestly, dig deep and ask yourself that, because when I wear these, I don't feel confident and I don't feel happy in them and I don't feel joyful and I don't feel like I'm getting value, and it makes me feel like, oh, I messed up and made a mistake. Like, I should have returned them. Again, you're coming at yourself with all these shoulds and shoulding all over yourself, and it's just not helpful. Like, I'm starting off my day immediately when I wake up and get dressed in the morning, I'm starting off my day very negative and very bad when I put these on, and that's just not worth it. So last question I ask myself, if I let this item go, will I feel lighter? Will I feel less heavy? Will I be able to take that bag of bricks off and that heaviness and let it go? And the truth is, getting rid of these black pants, this athletic top, and these jeans, do I feel lighter after getting rid of them? Yep, I do. Are there still emotions that I'm feeling right now with regards to letting them go? Yep, and that's okay. But the other thing, I've talked a little bit about language used, and this is something that I've been implementing that has been really beneficial in me letting go of items in my closet, is changing the language that I use with myself and even with others with regards to letting go of clothing items. So instead of asking myself the why question of, well, like, why did I purchase that? Why did I waste my money on that? Why did I buy it? Or I can't let go of it because I paid $50 for it, or I paid $100, or I paid $200 for it, whatever the amount is. Maybe it's even just $5. But I will shift my focus away from that money amount of, oh, I spent whatever amount on this, to, I thought this item would work, but it didn't. I thought this item would work, but it didn't. And I can let it go and let my fantasy self, or that specific weight that I thought that I would get to, I could let that go. And so I also tend to like imagine. So I will imagine in my mind's eye that someone else is wearing this workout top, this athletic top, but they find it at a thrift store. They couldn't have afforded this expensive brand otherwise. And they put this on and they feel like their best self. And they're working out and they're bettering themselves and they're gaining confidence, and this shirt itself brings them immense value. And I will imagine that in my mind, and that helps me to let go of that item, because the reality is that I'm not getting value from it. It's not making me feel like my best self, but I can give that feeling, that positive emotion, that confidence, I can give that and pass that on to someone else by just donating something that doesn't bring me value anymore. But that is a kind of that emotional process that I work through and go through that has helped me so much in letting go of the item. Because instead of focusing on myself, like, when we're picking apart and looking at items that we're letting go of out of our own closet, a lot of the times we're so self-focused on ourselves, right? Like, selfishly, we're focused on our weight, our body shape, our hips, right? All the parts of ourselves that we don't like, that we pick at, that's what we're focusing on. And this is me shifting my focus from, oh, I don't like the size of my waist, I don't like my hips, I don't like my arms, right? You're now focusing on, how can I bring beauty and confidence and give that to another woman? The other thing is, I also like to picture it as, like, I'm letting go of other items in my household that don't work. For example, I throw out food that gets moldy. And I kind of just do it without really thinking about it, right? I'll get rid of condiments. I'll get rid of items that are just old. And I can do that same thing with my closet. If you've made it this far in the video, you are a real one. Thank you so much for watching. I just want to give you guys some encouragement and say that no matter where you're at in this process and no matter how long it takes you, that's okay. I am proud of you for working through this process, working through your closet, working through some heavier emotions that are tied to those items. But I just want to let you know that it is okay to let those items go. I've found too that with this process, I'm not just letting go of that item. I'm letting go of shame. I'm letting go of guilt. I'm letting go of sadness. I'm letting go of this person that I thought I was going to be or this size that I thought I was going to be. And I let go of that and work towards accepting myself as I am. So thank you for coming on this process with me. Thank you so much. I love you all. Have a great rest of your week, and I will see you all in the next one.